I'm here in the channels report, and I got here by selecting channels from under all traffic within the acquisition reports. It's here that we can see all of our channel groups, like organic search and affiliates. And channel groupings are essentially rule-based groupings of your traffic sources. So there's a rule that Google applies automatically that says this search engine belongs in organic search. And it helps because you don't need to go out and manually add every single search engine into a group. Google simply applies the rule automatically at a system level. Affiliates is configured such that when you enter partners as your UTM source, it automatically appears in this bucket. Now, channel groups are incredibly helpful because it lets you look at data across a large channel so you can understand how your campaigns are influencing things from a high level. But it's very likely that you'd like to customize how Google Analytics groups channels or even create channel groups of your own. And to do that, we'll start by selecting admin in the lower left-hand corner. We'll then switch to the account that we're interested in working on. And then from under the view panel, I'll select channel settings. And then channel grouping. I'll select default channel grouping, and this allows us to see how the default channel groups are set up. We can see they're all system defined, and if I select edit next to social, you can see that the rule is the system defined channel matches social. Now, I will point out, Google is quick to let you know that any edits that you make to the default channel grouping will change how your traffic is classified. If you'd like to change the channel groups without changing any of the actual data, you can create a new channel group. And you do that simply by selecting custom channel grouping here on the left-hand side. So for starters, you can add rules. So within social, you can say the system-defined channel matches this, and then you can add in an additional rule, or you can change it to an or. If you'd like to remove the rule, simply select the minus icon. You also have the ability to change the color, and then simply select done if you want to save those changes. Now let's say we want to create a new channel and call this one influencer. Let's say, for example, we do a lot of campaigns with influencers, and we always set the custom UTM source to contain influencer. Here we can simply select source contains influencer, set the color, and choose done. And now whenever the source matches influencer, it'll automatically aggregate into that bucket, which allows us to view it at the channel grouping level, which is slightly different than viewing it at the campaign level. And furthermore, you can layer in more and more sources to aggregate into these custom channels. Channel groupings really allow you to further unlock and customize Google Analytics to fit your specific needs.